Hi everyone, and welcome. In this talk, we're going to cover the developer workflow and tools needed to deploy a custom machine learning model to mobile devices. My name is Adam Koch, a product manager working on TensorFlow and machine learning at Google. I'm joined by Arun, a fellow product manager, and YC, a software engineer who also both work on TensorFlow and machine learning. Today, we're going to trace the journey of a developer called Sam. Sam has an existing mobile app that allows users to apply unique edits to their photos. Sam receives a lot of user feedback, and one of the most popular user requests is the ability to transform photos into beautiful art portraits. Here you can see some examples of what a feature like this might look like, applied to photos of the speakers of this talk. Sam has some key requirements for this feature that should help guide the design and implementation. Let's go through them. First, both Android and iOS need to be supported. Second, user privacy is paramount. Photos should never leave users' devices. Third, processing of photos should happen quickly to ensure a great user experience. Fourth, a wide variety of hardware needs to be supported. Current users of the app have devices ranging from lower cost, less powerful smartphones, all the way to high-end smartphones with the latest chips. And finally, the feature should be easily updatable to add new art styles in the future. With these requirements in mind, Sam sets off to work out how to solve this problem. Sam knows this kind of feature will require machine learning using a technique called style transfer. Sam also has knowledge of the TensorFlow ecosystem and that it has support for deploying models across multiple platforms, including mobile and edge devices. Now let me pass you over to Arun, who will walk you through the various options Sam has available.
Thanks, Adam. Sam learns that both MLKit and the Google Cloud Platform provide turnkey solutions that work out of the box and contain simple implementations for common ML use cases such as vision and natural language. However, Sam does not find a turnkey solution that addresses their needs and moves on to explore other options. Sam learns about the TensorFlow Hub, a repository of trained machine learning models ready for fine-tuning and deploying in production. Sam also comes across the TensorFlow Model Garden, a repository with a number of different implementations of state-of-the-art models and modeling solutions for TensorFlow users. Sam does not find a model that fits their needs. Another option available to Sam is to use a tool like the TensorFlow Lite Model Maker, which allows them to create a TensorFlow Lite model on their own data using transfer learning on existing models. Sam learns that none of these options may work for their use case. Sam explores further and understands that they need to start from a custom TensorFlow model, either building one from scratch, which involves an enormous amount of training data, or selecting an existing TensorFlow model and then optimizing it for mobile and other edge devices. Sam reaches out to the awesome TensorFlow Lite community, who helps Sam discover an existing TensorFlow model that fit their needs. Now the challenge is to convert and optimize the TensorFlow model to run well on mobile. Sam learns that the first step is to convert a TensorFlow saved model or Keras model to the TensorFlow Lite model format. These models can then be optimized to improve performance. Once these models are optimized, they can be deployed on Sam's mobile application. Before diving into the model conversion, let us help Sam understand the TensorFlow Lite architecture and how to leverage it for Sam's use case. Recall that Sam's first step is to convert a TensorFlow model to the TensorFlow Lite model format. Sam uses the TensorFlow Lite converter to generate a corresponding TensorFlow Lite model. Sam's new model needs to run on CPUs, which are available on all mobile devices. In order to run Sam's newly converted TensorFlow Lite model, the TensorFlow Lite interpreter calls into highly optimized CPU kernels built for optimum performance. In addition to base performance on the CPU, SAM would also like to leverage on-device accelerators such as the GPU for improved peak performance. TensorFlow Lite delegates allow a part or the entire graph to be executed on accelerators such as the GPU for potential performance gains. We will cover performance aspects in a later part of this talk. Now that SAM understands how the converter works, SAM uses the Python API to convert the TensorFlow model to the TensorFlow Lite format. TensorFlow Lite also provides a set of tools for developers such as SAM to easily analyze their model structure. For example, SAM can use the model analyzer to easily understand which ops in the model are supported on the GPU. This insight allows SAM to potentially replace TensorFlow Lite ops not supported on the GPU with other mathematically equivalent GPU-supported ops when they have access to the model code. In the future, if SAM decides to author a custom TensorFlow model from scratch for deployment on mobile, TensorFlow Lite also provides the target-aware authoring tool to detect model and hardware compatibility issues early during the authoring time. Excellent! SAM now has a TensorFlow Lite model that can actually run on a mobile device. Unfortunately, an initial test of the model shows that it's slow to process an image, which does not make for a great user experience. In addition, the model size is quite large, which will increase the app size. SAM realizes that the TensorFlow Lite model needs to be optimized for mobile to make it run faster and also reduce its size to prevent application bloat. I will now hand it over to Adam to talk about model optimization.
Thanks, Arun. SAM now needs to tune the model to run efficiently. This is a key step when preparing a custom model for production. So how can SAM optimize the model? We provide something called TensorFlow Model Optimization Toolkit, which provides techniques such as quantization that lead to smaller models with more efficient compute. This is really important for on-device use cases like mobile that inherently have limitations on resources such as compute, memory, and battery. However, these advantages need to be balanced versus model quality, so it's important for SAM to be able to measure and benchmark the model to understand the trade-offs and if those trade-offs make sense for SAM's use case. One technique that the Model Optimization Toolkit provides is post-training quantization. As the name implies, it is applied to a model after training. There are a variety of quantization schemes to choose from. As you can see from the code, it's actually quite straightforward to apply quantization. So what's the catch? The converter will apply the chosen optimization technique. However, it's up to SAM, the model author, to not only verify the resulting improvements to model size and performance, but also to understand how model accuracy is affected, and if this trade-off was indeed worth it based on SAM's requirements. So how can SAM get better insight into what effect quantization is having on the model? Quantization Debugger provides SAM with insight to understand and debug where accuracy is affected in the model. It compares the inputs and outputs of the quantized model to the float model, providing helpful metrics to better understand the effects of quantization. In this example, we can see that layer 12 of the model has higher than expected error metrics, which means it's likely the layer was not quantized effectively and may be causing overall model accuracy to drop. Okay, so SAM has identified a problematic layer. How can this be addressed? Selective post-training quantization allows skipping quantization for some nodes, so calculations can happen in the original floating point domain. For example, here we see how SAM can skip quantization for any node using a specific op. This will help recover some model quality at the cost of some increase in model size and inference latency. Fantastic! SAM's model is now smaller, and a simple test shows it running at a good speed. However, SAM wonders how best to benchmark the model on a real device to collect more accurate real-world data. In addition, SAM needs to work out how to ensure the model can run well on a variety of devices. Let me pass you over to YC, to tell you more about device performance and benchmarking.
Thanks, Adam. Sense app may be used by millions of people with both high-end and low-end devices. Sam notes that CPU performance is important because it's available everywhere. TensorFlow Lite has been providing optimized CPU implementation for ARM since its initial release, and recently we start to leverage the XNNPack library to provide an even better performance. XNNPack is a library maintained by Google, which provides highly optimized numerical computation for ARM, x86, and WebAssembly platforms. It supports floating-point and quantized computation, and health precision inference is coming soon. XNNPack is now turned on by default in C++ API since TensorFlow Lite 2.7. We have also recently enabled it by default on the native build in the Java API. Therefore, Sam only needs to upgrade the TensorFlow Lite version to benefit from the newest CPU optimizations. In addition to CPU, Sam also knows that a lot of modern mobile devices have on-device accelerators, which may run machine learning models faster. Sam earlier learned about TensorFlow Lite's architecture and its support for running inferences using on-device accelerators. Sam can easily try different accelerators using TensorFlow Lite's delegates. Sam can use GPU delegate or NNAPI delegate on Android. On iOS, there are GPU delegate and core ML delegates that Sam can try. While using on-device accelerators can result in a significant performance improvement, there is a variation in runtime latency and stability across different devices and delegates. We are addressing this via the acceleration service for Android to help determining the optimum hardware on which to run machine learning inference safely at runtime. You can get more information on this in the What's New in Android Machine Learning session. Sam has tried running the model both on the CPU as well as the GPU and other accelerators. However, it's also important for Sam to ensure that processing of photos is quick enough to provide a great user experience. So, how can Sam get a better idea of the TensorFlow Lite model performance in the real-world scenarios? TensorFlow Lite provides a model benchmarking tool that allows developers such as Sam to easily measure and provide the performance of their models on real physical devices. Using the benchmarking tool, Sam can try benchmarking different models with different on-device configurations, such as setting the delegate options and the number of threads. The tool also helps understanding which operators are time-consuming to future optimize the model. Great! Now Sam is confident that the model will run performantly, and the next step is shipping the features to millions of users on different platforms. Sam also hopes to be able to release the style transfer feature and also iterate on the style and model quality. Sam now starts to work on deployment, which is the last mile to deliver the feature to users. Sam is now ready to deploy the optimized model to Android and iOS. Sam can use the TensorFlow Lite Java API for Android and Swift or Objective-C API for iOS for the integration. To Sam's delight, Sam also finds out that the same TensorFlow Lite model can also be used on other devices and surfaces. Sam can bring the same photo editing feature to web, Raspberry Pi, and desktop operating systems. This ability to create a model that can be deployed across multiple platforms is a key benefit of using TensorFlow Lite. It helps developers like Sam to leverage the same set of tools and codebase for multi-platform deployment. Whenever Sam wants to update the model quality or even add a new type of style, Sam only needs to let the app to download a new model file over the internet without having to update the entire app binary. Sam can manage his deployment of custom models manually or can take advantage of Firebase, which has a suite of tools to simplify this process. Lastly, SAM can take advantage of the TensorFlow Lite in Google Play Service feature, which is now publicly available in beta. This will reduce the app's binary size, since SAM no longer need to link the TensorFlow Lite binary with the app. The app also gets benefit from TensorFlow Lite's latest updates, which will automatically be delivered by Google Play Service to users' devices. You can hear more about this in the What's New in Android Machine Learning talk. That brings us to the end of SAM's story. SAM is ready to release the feature to users and is happy about the result. No matter where you are in the developer journey, we have tools to support you. From finding the right turnkey solutions to building custom models, optimizing the models, benchmarking and providing the model performance, and deployment to deliver the features to users. Please check out the TensorFlow Lite website for all this information. If you run into issues, you can also get help from the amazing TensorFlow community on the TensorFlow forum. That's it. Thanks for listening.